Shh! It's a library?
I'm here in Battersham at one of seven libraries in the North London area threatened with closure under the City Council's new budget proposals. With Battersham Library's future hanging in the balance, campaigners are describing the proposed closure as an act of cultural vandalism. As you can see behind me, staff and patrons of Battersham are holding a vigorous and heartfelt protest.
Guys, this is us.
Where do we want them?
Where am I?
What do we want?
Sir, why are you here today?
Why am I here today? If they close this library down, where are me and my family going to get our books from? Well, oh, I just noticed there's a bookshop over there, actually. And, Amazon, of course.
If this library closes, then that's my sex life out the window.
Why am I here? Well, there's many reasons. I think,
Waterstones.
Oh, come on. I said way more than that.
Other libraries. There's one not far, actually. Bit bigger. Free Wi-Fi. Has a coffee shop. Why am I here?
Well, there you have it. Battersham Library's set for closure within 3 weeks, unless a new source of funding can be found. Library manager Troy Bennett, pictured here in camouflage, has declined to comment. George O'Brien, BNC News, Battersham.
Turn it off. London. Forget it. Don't you guys have work to do? Come on. Steve?
Well?
According to the inventory, there's a book missing. I may be wrong, but, could you look up 37-B?
Can't believe we never computerized our records.
No, take it up with Troy.
My God. Damn it!
How could you bring this thing into my library? Now listen, I don't want any more of your excuses. What are you, some kind of book queer? Back in my day, we used to read real books. You see these scars, boy? They're paper cuts from actually handling real books!
Do you know what this is?
No, Grandpa Troy.
It's my will. And you are not in it anymore. You, what's your name?
Steve.
Steve, you're my new grandson now. Tomorrow we go fishing. Huh? How you like them apples?
Sir?
Quit bugging me about fishing already, will ya?
Sir, I think our financial troubles might be over.
Over? What do you mean over?
This is an overdue library fee, sir. From 1989.
What are you trying to tell me?
Rory the Dinosaur, sir. The book still hasn't been returned. And if my calculations are correct, including annual fees, adjustment for inflation, this man owes us approximately £1 million.
Who is this guy? Michael? Foster.
Am I speaking to a Michael Foster?
Yeah.
Hello, Mr. Foster. This is Steve Hadley calling from Battersham Library.
Battersham? I've never heard of it.
Yeah, we're having that problem. Listen, I'm calling regarding an overdue book.
No?
Yeah, Rory the Dinosaur, recommended...
Reading age 3 to 9. Is this ringing any bells?
Look, there's no easy way of saying this, but you owe us £1 million.
No? Sorry, I've got a call on the other line.
Hey, man. I am so sorry to hear about you and Rachael.
Really sucks. You okay?
I'll be fine. No, it's...
Yeah, it's fine. Listen, I'm on the phone to Battersby Library.
Never heard of them.
Yeah, they're having that problem.
Yeah?
Yeah, apparently I owe them £1 million.
I know what this is about. It's about Rachael, isn't it?
But no, it's not about Rachael. It's
a man. There are plenty more fish in the sea, okay? And you're a good-looking lad.
Alright, thanks.
For your age.
I'm 25.
Really? Shit, when did that happen?
Look, I know me and Rachael didn't exactly get on.
Oh, don't start on that.
No, just hear me out. Look, all I'm saying is, I'm here for you.
Do you have £1 million?
No. Wait, what?
I owe the library £1 million.
No one owes the library £1 million. If this is a scam, they're not even trying. Look, tell them if they want to pursue this...
That your hotshot lawyer friend, Jason Smythe...
McDougal... Hines... is going to take them to court and sue them for every penny they have.
Jason, they're not idiots.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Right.
What is he saying, boy? Spit it out!
He's saying that he's going to get his hotshot lawyer friend, Jason Smythe McDougal Hines, to sue us for every penny we've got.
Hines, yeah. Oh yeah, I heard of him.
Give me the phone.
Now you listen to me, boy. I don't care if you got Hines.
You owe me $1 million.
It's pounds, sir.
Even better.
Now you pay up, or my grandson's going to send the boys round.
Do you mind if I put you on hold?
Okay, sure, I'll wait.
Jason, this might be more serious than we thought.
Do they believe you?
No, but... kind of.
Are you sure this isn't about Rachael?
Look... This is not about Rachael.
Rachael? Who's Rachael? This is Troy.
Troy who?
Bennett! Troy Bennett! Who's this?
This is Michael. Michael Foster.
Oh, yeah, you!
You owe me $1 million!
Pounds.
Yeah, pounds, whatever. Who's Rachael?
Rachael? The Rachael thing... I was talking to Jason.
The lawyer?
No, my friend.
Ah! So who's he?
How did you get his number?
Never mind, you're confusing the shit out of me! You find this Rachael girl, and wait a minute! Send in the boys too!
Are you doing anything? Jason, are you doing anything? Oh, shut up, you've never met my mum. Have you? I need a place that I can go because right now, I'm just locked in my room. Quick!
What was quick?
I'm on the phone!
There are men outside my house.
You're serious about this, aren't you?
Yeah.
Okay. How many are there and do they have guns?
2 men. I didn't see any guns. But you've said it now. Oh, they're gone.
No! There they are!
We got him.
Steve!
Ignorant faces, I saw my laces, the laser on the underground.
Steve!
That's what it's...
Hey, Steve! Steve! Stevie!
gravity pretty good, huh?
We have a visual going live on the house, sir.
Good. We have audio?
Yes, sir.
On the house?
Ah.
That's what I thought.
I just came in and I wanted to get a coffee.
Steve, do you know what happened to the last man who just wanted a coffee?
Easy coffee, sir.
Thank you.
Careful now, it's hot.
I would hope so.
I mean, we don't even have Wi-Fi.
Desperate times call for desperate measures, Steve. We're saving my... our library. Hey! Hey, you! This isn't a cafeteria! Report to Squad 6, soldier!
Sir? How are we affording this? I thought we were going bankrupt.
Ah. Well?
Ready to begin the interrogation, sir.
Oh, thank God.
Interrogation?
It's Rachael. We got her.
And you're interrogating her?
Don't you worry about a thing, boy. I got my best man on it.
Rachael, you know why you're here, don't you?
No.
Do you know a man named Michael?
Where's good cop?
What?
Well, I presume you're bad cop.
I'm not a cop. I'm a librarian.
Tell me about Michael!
I know a lot of Michaels. Why don't you have a gun?
What?
Well, the guys had guns. The men who came to my house all had guns.
Right. So?
Well, I just thought you'd have a gun. It doesn't matter. It's fine.
Do I need a gun?
You? No.
I need a gun. Give me a gun.
No.
Come on.
No.
Please.
No.
I don't need a gun. Look. No gun.
No shades either. The men earlier had shades.
Look. Help me out here.
What did Michael do?
Come up with a few plans. Okay? First things first. Do you have a helipad on your roof that you haven't told me about?
No.
Ah. Okay, this changes things. I know. We go to my uncle's house.
Does he have a helipad on his roof?
Well, not on the roof. But he has guns.
No, I'm not shooting anybody.
All right, fine. Do you still have it?
What?
The book you borrowed.
What, Rory the Dinosaur? I must do somewhere.
We have to find it.
not what we were looking for.
No, I just thought we could take a break and read for a bit.
So it begins.
Battle stations, everybody, man your positions! I want all eyes on the bogey! Get in, come up here right away! I want to know what the hell that thing was!
Sir, we've got a satellite image.
Oh, that was quick.
Screen one, enhance it! I can see it's a goddamn book!
Sir, I think it's the book.
I don't care about the book.
I thought if I gave the book back, they'd leave you alone.
But why'd you tie it to a brick?
That's what you do.
No, that's what you do when you throw something into someone's... I owe them £1 million!
Well, all right, mate. I'm not here to help you.
Don't give me that. No,
I came all the way from my house.
Don't
I'm going to feed my
Jason,
cat.
Jason,
you hit me with a...
Jason. Were there any men in the back garden?
No.
And he didn't think to... Couldn't just...
You've got a plan.
I do.
They've been in there since Hector was a pup.
Sir, Mr. Muscle.
Talk to me.
We're inside the house.
He's gone.
Suspect is in his mid-20s, I would
say. Male.
I know he's a male.
Lives alone.
Yeah, very interesting.
Commitment
very
issues.
Okay, I need to know more about the suspect.
Definitely white.
You're not telling me what I need to know. This information is superfluous.
Possibly gay.
That is not even the point. I need information from you.
Reasonable taste in music.
That's not what I meant.
Actually, scratch that last. Completely.
Listen.
Kitchen could do with a once-over.
Are you listening
Maybe
to me?
A bit of flash.
Flash, really?
Flash is for bathrooms.
Still were.
The suspect, Foster!
How did he escape?
Well... The evidence suggests that the suspect approached the back door.
Opened it.
And he just walked through. He just walked through the back door, boss. Boss?
You there?
Damn it. I always forget about that goddamn back door.
It's the President.
Mr. President, I'm a big fan of your work.
Is this Captain Bennett?
Sir.
Captain Troy Bennett?
The one and only, sir.
I wanted to thank you personally, Captain. Capturing General Ho Shin Lin will ensure stability in this region. You've saved thousands of lives, son.
Thank you, sir.
Now, you're sure you have him surrounded?
Absolutely. We have every conceivable exit covered.
God bless you, son.
And God bless America. All right, you pansies, let's make this quick.
Go, go, go!
Where's the general? The back door. I'll never make this mistake again.
Any change, Cuff?
Is this your answer to everything?
Nice. I just bought you that.
Yeah, with my money.
Exactly. Something you should be saving right now.
Yeah.
Shh. Act natural. We need to blend in.
Why?
You don't know who's working for the library. Could be anyone.
You're saying anyone could be a librarian?
Mate, for all you know, I could be a librarian. But you're not. Aren't I?
Are you?
No.
You're right.
Alright.
He looks so sus.
Huh?
Suspicious. Look at him. He's got a book in his hand. Where did he get that from?
A shop.
Perhaps. Or maybe he got it from the library.
I got it from a shop.
He's probably lying.
No, I'm not.
He's got a goatee.
That he has.
Let me talk to your boss.
You do not want to do that. Rachel, soon you tell me where your boyfriend is.
Michael's not my boyfriend.
What?
We broke up.
Oh. When did that happen?
That's none of your business. We needed space. I don't know where he is. How much does he even owe your boss?
$1 million.
Dollars?
Pounds.
Oh. Oh, that's much worse.
Give me your phone.
You do realise Michael doesn't have £1 million.
You don't know my boss. Rachel, your phone, please.
Oh, I've got to get this. Careful, it could be anyone. Hi, Rachel.
Oh, boring.
Mr. Foster, my name's Will Clark.
You're not Rachel.
No, sir, my name's Will Clark. I'm calling from Battersham Library. We've kidnapped your girlfriend.
Ex.
Your ex-girlfriend.
What have you done to her?
Nothing.
Yet.
They've handcuffed me.
We've handcuffed her.
Mike, can I get another drink? Do you want one?
Listen, meet us in the library with the money by 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Or what?
I'm really dehydrated.
Listen, I don't have £1 million, so...
9 a.m. tomorrow. I'm sorry.
They've got Rachel.
So let me get this straight. The manager of Battersham Library has kidnapped your girlfriend.
Ex-girlfriend.
Right. And this is because...
Things weren't working out, we needed some space.
No, why has this man kidnapped your girlfriend?
We see I owe him £1 million. For a book that I took out in the 80s.
Right.
Son, we all did some crazy shit in the 80s.
Sure?
This one time, me and the gang stole a grandfather clock from the lobby of old man Connor's shoe factory, and then we sailed it down the weir. As far as Bishop Auckland, I believe. Maybe further. Finest clock I ever knew. Boy, those cobblers were pissed.
Guys, I'm sure this is all just a misunderstanding.
Well, it isn't, okay? So...
Maybe if you just go back to the library and talk to this Troy Bennett, it can all be resolved. I'm sure he's a perfectly reasonable man.
I am not a reasonable man!
Sir, I said unreasonable.
Oh, I see. Sorry.
Can't we just let her go?
Are you crazy? That's crazy talk. You crazy!
Yeah, but sir, she's not even his girlfriend anymore. She's his ex.
Then she's of no use to us. She's a liability.
Kill her.
Sir?
She's collateral damage, boy. What's the matter? You don't want to follow my orders, huh? Because if you don't want to do it, I got 100 men who will!
I don't think you do.
I'll do it.
Will!
You know, I like you, Will. I can see you taking over this dump one day. When I'm gone.
Thanks, that'll, thanks.
Get out of here.
Well, what are you doing? You just standing here? Go join Squad 3 and start up that sniper's nest!
I want to set up a kill zone.
So what exactly are we preparing for? This Michael Foster is just one guy.
Never underestimate your enemy, Steve. Remember that.
Sure.
need guns. Loads and loads of guns.
We're gonna die. Because of a book.
You're gonna die? They don't even know who I am. I'm Mr. Incognito.
Police aren't gonna help.
Yeah, they never do.
In the movies, no one goes to the police.
They're doing police movies.
True that. My uncle has guns!
Oddly okay with this. I was not really my uncle. He's just some guy who moved in next door when I was 7. If I called him uncle, he'd let me play with his guns. Did he touch you? No! Did you touch him?
Piss off!
I want to see the manager.
Knock, knock. Troy?
This is not the wrong number!
If you're calling for Troy Bennett, Troy can't come to the phone right now because he's busy running his goddamn library. So, hello, I'm Troy Bennett, and you're not Troy Bennett. So don't even think about it. There's only one Troy Bennett, and that is me. Please leave a message for Troy Bennett after the beep.
Troy! What's up, dude? My butt! Troyster! Troymanator! Troy Story 2, man, right? Leonard Neem. Troy, your bank account, buddy, the Swiss one, not the legal one, ready for the next deposit. This is the big one, man. Said the lawyer to the hooker. No, fuck. I said the hooker to the priest. Listen, they're gonna be expecting that £1 million, I mean, minus my 5% lawyer's privileges, by noon tomorrow. It's kind of a dick move to keep all the money for yourself and give nothing back to the library, but hey, 5%, not complaining. I'm just your lawyer. That was a high five. I high-fived the phone. So you should, if you would like to, you could high-five it back, Troy. Really hope no one's listening to this message. That'd be really awkward. I mean, because they don't know who I am, but if they were to listen, they know who you are. They know you! Hey, look, I'm going to see you on Thursday on the golf course there, buddy. Drinks are on you, you brilliant asshole! Peace!
So it's come to this, huh? My own grandson betrays me.
What the hell?
I will deal with you later.
Troy! Troy, get back here, you bastard!
Okay, people, look alive! Give me status report.
Mr. Johnson, losing them fast.
Send in squads 1 through 5.
Been 6.
I really hope I'm the one that catches this guy.
Yeah.
Hey, do you know what Troy said to me last week?
What did he say?
He said that he could see me running this place one day.
You running a library?
Oh, yes. Why not?
What do you know about books?
Absolutely nothing. But maybe I'm getting sick of this wee mercenary malarkey.
Yeah, yeah.
I never even fired this thing. Do you know what I don't get? I don't get why they've gone to so much effort just to catch some loser.
Must have their reasons.
Yeah, like what?
I don't know. Reasons.
Oh, come on! It's hardly likely that some random civilian's gonna charge into this place holding a grenade now, is it?
You had to say it.
There's a war going on out there. Troy sent me here to kill you.
Well, what are you waiting for? Do it.
Sticks and stones may break my bones,
but words will never hurt me.
Bullshit.
Can you go out with the body?
Where is she?
You made a pretty good bad cop.
Thanks.
And you've got a gun now.
Kick her in the shin!
Can't do that, she's older than my knife.
You were shooting at her?
Warning shot, Jason. I wasn't actually gonna shoot her, I wasn't.
Fuck you!
You're a book out.
Bible.
Which one? Holy?
Check it. Torah.
Lachaim.
What?
Chuck it!
The Introduction to Scientology Ethics.
Yeah, definitely tell that one, isn't it?
Quran. Jason?
I wouldn't.
Another Torah?
I can't fight. There's not another one here, Jason. There's only one Torah.
Oh. I think I'm having... Oh, dear.
What's happening? She's having a coronary.
A what?
It's a heart attack. Say that, then.
Should we shoot her?
I was going to say help her, actually.
Mate, there's nothing we can do. She's having a coronary.
A coronary.
That too. This is more serious than we thought.
I never liked libraries.
What? What's wrong with libraries?
They're too quiet.
Too quiet.
Hello? Anybody? Steve?
Will? Steve! Mate, are you in there?
Yeah, obviously. Troy's gone insane.
Is he in there?
No, he's just locked me in.
Oh.
Have you tried kicking the door down?
Yeah, I tried that. Twice. I think I fractured my ankle. Twice.
Shit, Steve.
Can you walk?
No, I'm trapped in an office. Who's that?
Steve, meet Rachael. Rachael, Steve.
Who?
What?
Steve, Rachael is Michael Foster's ex.
Troy kidnapped her on the cover of darkness and we've been holding her hostage in the library until about,
I don't know, 10 minutes ago?
Alright, okay. Nice to meet you, Rachael.
Likewise.
Rachael, Steve works here.
I'm trapped in an office.
And he's trapped in an office.
It's okay, I spent most of my day trapped in a cupboard.
Did you try kicking the door down?
Wait, both of you, stand back.
What?
Try now.
No, it's still locked, mate.
No, I thought that would work.
And there goes the last of your bullets. Well done.
Shit. Wait, no. Yeah, Steve!
Troy has a spare set of keys.
Where?
Behind the clock, I think.
That clock?
Well, probably.
Okay. Who puts their keys behind a clock?
Exactly. Can you help, Steve?
Give me a sec.
Yeah, sure. Don't worry about it.
Take your time. It's not as though we have...
Care to explain what's going on here, sir?
Yeah, you're right, Will. Keys behind the clock.
Mate, not now.
But it's the key to every door in the friggin' library. Seriously, there's dozens of them. Guys, this might just be the worst escape plan ever. And I might have just broken Troy's lamp. He's gonna kill us.
Like, actually kill us.
Mate, this isn't what I expected to do when I came into work this morning. Put some books in boxes, get written into the boss's will, kill the boss. Will? Will?
Steve, we've got a situation out here!
Do something!
Grab his gun!
Oh, it's a damn shame, Will. I liked you. Could have seen you running this dump one day. Let's go. Bring the girl.
Mr. Foster.
Welcome to our... Well, my library.
Your visit here is overdue. Now listen carefully, Mr. Foster.
I'm listening.
He can't hear you.
Shh.
I've got somebody up here that you care about.
Very much. Your girlfriend, Mr. Foster.
Ex.
When did that happen?
Things weren't working out. She needed space.
All right. I'm not a very patient man, Mr. Foster, or a reasonable one.
If you ever hope to see your ex-girlfriend again,
you better bring my £1 million up to the rooftop at this very instant.
Or you know what will happen to her. I'll kill her, Mr. Foster.
That's what I meant.
Shit, man. We've got to save Rachael. Which way to the roof? Up.
Okay, well, I'm coming with you.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Will, oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, we're gonna get you through this. Just breathe, breathe. We're gonna be fine. Shh. Tell me to shush.
This is a library, Steve. It's so peaceful. It's finally quiet.
Seven, 208, 209, 200. Ah, Mr. Foster. We meet at last.
Now, I'm Jason.
What?
Yeah, that's Mr. Foster.
All right.
Well, then who are you?
Oh, it's just Jason.
Just a mate.
Yeah.
What is this, bring a friend to work day? Is that a thing? We should do that. Later.
Well, Mr. Foster, we meet at last. Again.
Let's just get this over with, Troy.
Nice boy. What is this, some kind of sick joke?
Where's my money? This is nothing but stupid books!
You've forgotten what really matters, Mr. Bennett, sir.
The books, Troy. It was always about the books. Real paper books.
Jason, now!
Ah! No!
Oh, yeah. So? You thought you could distract me with books, huh? Thought you could outwit Troy Bennett. Delta Company, 2nd Battalion Airborne, 502nd Airborne Infantry, 101st Airborne Division, 3 silver stars for gallantry,
3 bronze stars for heroism, 8 purple hearts for cake decoration.
So what? I've got a badge for the RSPCA. Does that mean I'm gonna shoot people?
If your dog was here right now, I'd kill your fucking dog.
Ah! Here we are. 2200 hours. Perfect!
Well, Mr. Foster, I do believe that my lift has arrived. It's time to leave this stinking library.
With or without
my 1,000,000 pounds.
Without you, bastard, you're not getting a penny.
Troy, that's enough!
Finish him off. Starting with her.
This library is now officially closed!
You leave her with us! You forgot your most important passenger! It's me! Where are you going?
Well, this is something.
What if our boss catches us?
He left hours ago, Jamie. He's not gonna catch us. Come on.
See, I told you this was a good idea.
You liar!
Nobody does romance like librarians, Sarah.
Okay.
I'm serious. We're famous for it. Librarians are S-E-X-Y. Don't laugh. We've written the book about it. Well, at least they stamped it. Are you sure no one's gonna...
Who's gonna interrupt us at 10 o'clock at night on the roof of the Battersea Library?
I specifically told them, batter sham. I bet those bastards at Battersea have my goddamn chopper. This is so typical. This is just like my Sumatran rhinoceros all over again. I paid good money for that rhino. Critically endangered my ass. What do you got to say for yourself now, dinosaur boy, huh? Well, I got a bestseller for you! This is your final chapter, Mr. Foster. Never really liked this goddamn library anyway. You'd need 1,000 books like that to hurt me, girl. And the last time I looked, you can't carry 1,000.
No, but this can.
How could you bring that into my library?
Never really about the books, was it, Troy?
I guess that's the fishing trip cancelled.
Ignored my instincts.
You're alive.
I ignored who I really am. And that will never happen again.
Jason, it's Michael.
It's Wolverine.
Oh, he's concussed.
I've been shot.
Well.
Thrice.
I fractured my ankle. I'm gonna call an ambulance.
Can you make it an air ambulance?
Yeah, we're gonna get you out. Don't worry, it's fine.
See what I'm worried about?
What are you worried about me for?
Yeah, look at you two back together.
No way.
We're not.
Oh, I missed you, babe. Oh, I missed you too. Oh, come here, I'll give you a kiss.
Jason.
And then you were like...
Jason. I know you've been shot, mate.
Thrice!
I know you've been shot thrice, but I am not above slapping you, all right?
I've still got the gun.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
Not a massive fan of violence, don't.
Happy neighbour.
Coward's way out.
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Hello, Battersea Library? Yeah. We're gonna need our helicopter back.
Certainly, madam. I can reserve that for you. Yeah, this evening's fine. No, it's Thursday today. Which means we're open till 9. Now we had to extend the hours because of the rush.
Is the manager in?
My client, Mr. Hadley, as clearly stated in Mr. Bennett's will, is the sole heir and executor of his grandfather's fortune.
This document is legally binding. Mr. Stephen Hadley shall inherit the Bennett fortune.
Thank you so much.
Call me Jason.
Jason, yeah, of course, sorry.
Jason Smythe McDougall Hines.
The greatest lawyer to ever walk the halls of Battersham County Court.
I'll drink to that.